Do you feel emotionally distant from your partner? You know, it's really important that couples talk about this because when you're so intimate with someone, there's going to have to be ways that you distance yourself once in a while from each other without hurting the other. The important thing is if this has been going on, and you mention it on the fly or you don't really take time to talk about it or reflect how each of you are feeling, it can turn into so much distance that one of the partners starts looking for another partner. And this is really the beginning of emotional affairs, of physical affairs, and of all other forms of betrayal. So if you're feeling emotionally distant from your partner, I'm going to give you 5 things to consider why it might be happening. But it's really important that you follow it up, because remember, you and your partner are both in this together. But that doesn't mean you're both going to feel about it or be able to talk about it the same. So one of you has to step up and broach the conversation. The first one is your partner craves alone time. Many times when a partner feels like they need space or they've got a lot going on, they don't know how to talk to their partner about it. So what they do is they'll just withdraw emotionally, and that's very hurtful. If you're feeling your partner is doing this, like withdrawing, then the first thing you should do is ask them, do you feel like you need more space? Am I crowding you? And listen to what they say. Try not to get defensive, but rather remember, you're investigating, you're trying to figure this out and work on it together. Secondly, maybe your partner is losing that loving feeling or that connection. Sometimes when there's so much distance between a relationship, one of the partners will start questioning, you know, why are we together? What do we share? We can't really talk about things. We're non-communicative. Can we learn that, or should we just hang it up? It's in this stage, and it's really important that you guys talk about it. But if you're avoiding the talk and your partner is withdrawing, then nothing's going to happen. And these are the most common divorces. The main reason they divorce is because they feel like they drifted apart. They drifted apart because they lost the feeling and they didn't know how to talk about reconnecting. Your partner might be anxious, sad, depressed, or suffer some other kind of mental illness that they're kind of keeping to themselves because they're not aware of it, or they're so deep into their own isolation, they don't know how to get out of it. Talking to your partner about and realizing, you know, you looked really sad this morning at breakfast, or I've noticed you just seem to be apathetic. You don't care about me. You don't really care about what we're doing. Is something going on with you? If you will talk to your partner, many times what you'll find is they have been suffering and they've been doing it silently because they feel shameful or they don't understand it and they're afraid you'll reject them. Very important that couples are there for each other and that this is the very stuff they talk about, because if your partner is really depressed, they're going to need your help in seeking some kind of mental health care. And don't forget, during the pandemic, a lot of therapists are working online, so it's not the way it used to be. You don't have to go into the office necessarily, but you do need to start the search for finding someone who can help you and your partner as you work through this depression or sadness or whatever it is going on with them together. A cycle of avoiding or pursuing. Sometimes when couples don't know how to ask for space, one will withdraw, and then that makes the other feel really scared and they'll cling on more. So if you're feeling like you guys are withdrawing lately, you want to check out and make sure that it's not just your reaction to their withdrawing. And if they are withdrawing, what is going on underneath that? Opening a space, and I keep saying this because it's so important, giving them a space to be honest without feeling like they're going to be attacked or hurt you is so important. And if more couples allow that into their relationship, I think that they will find that they can work so many things out together And it won't turn into something chaotic where even therapy can't help it anymore. And the last thing, and probably the most toxic of all patterns in all relationships, is a cycle of criticism and withdrawal. What happens with this, and I think it's safe to say most couples get into this at sometimes if they've been in a long-term relationship. You've probably done it, I know I have. Your partner, for whatever reason, withdraws. And rather than you seeking what's going on, you react. And as they withdraw, you become more critical. You start showing them verbally. You start saying things with your words that are hurtful and critical of who they are. And you don't stop at just the behaviors in the relationship. You know all this personal stuff about them, so you continue to criticize the really personal, hurtful things, breaking a boundary. It feels like a deep betrayal. When you get into this pattern, the most important thing you can do is get a hold of yourself and talk to a therapist. A therapist is going to help you deal with past resentment, past hurt, feeling neglected, feeling unattended to. Those feelings, when you deal with them and they are yours, can help you heal the relationship. You can go back to your partner, and the therapist probably will have your partner come in too. But before you can work on the relationship, you have to get control and begin managing some of these feelings you're feeling so that you can say them clearly and non-hurtfully to your partner. It's a very important, precious part of all good relationships, is they're able to deal with this aspect when it does come up. When the relationship becomes most of the time this way, it will kill it. I usually tell couples, practice the 80-20% rule. That means the positives have to be 80% and the criticism less than 20% for a relationship to restore and grow in a healthy manner. So if you feel like you're locked in one of those patterns, and many couples are, with the occurring stressors, with the pandemic, financial worries, long summers, nowhere to go, I really encourage you to talk to a therapist today. There is a light at the end of the tunnel.